Today I want to talk about Sam Ehlinger and the eyes of Texas and all that's coming up after the bumper.
Don't be cornering me. Hold up. Time. You gotta help me with that corner s***.
What's up, kinfolk? It's RJ Young. I am not on a step mill. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. It's always college football related, sports related. We have a good time. Today, I want to talk about this narrative around Sam Ehlinger being the only Longhorn player who stood for the eyes of Texas being played outside, or I should say, by the band, inside the Cotton Bowl. Now, most of the team had already gone inside after suffering what was a debilitating loss for many, 53-45 to Oklahoma in the 116th edition of the Red River Rivalry. Fun fact, it was the highest scoring in the series history dating back to 2018 when actually Texas won that game 48-45. Now, as it pertains to Sam Ehlinger standing for the eyes of Texas, there's several different ways to look at this, but I think that Sam Ehlinger's narrative is dominating the one that actually matters. Ehlinger, by all accounts, good dude, sound dude, right? Really believes in the University of Texas, really believes in being its quarterback, really wanted to be that guy for the University of Texas. He's 1-4 against Oklahoma, but that's beside the point. Most folks would tell you Sam Ehlinger is just a quality dude. Well, earlier this summer, at the height of Black Lives Matter, Black players like Caden Stearns said they no longer wanted to stand and be made to sing the Eyes of Texas. Why? Because the Eyes of Texas is based on a racist song in origin. This dates back to Robert E. Lee, back when he was president at Washington in Lexington, Virginia, when he had a student named William Prather. William Prather went to the University of Texas to become its president, I think 1899 to 1905. And during that time, students adopted "The Eyes of the South Are Upon You" and "I've Been Working on the Railroad," which is the same melody, to become "The Eyes of Texas Are Upon You." That has racist imagery. You can understand why Black football players might not want to participate in anything that glorifies the South as the Confederacy. They also would not want to participate in anything that would see them enslaved, right? I think that when most people are talking about this, they forget that. They also forget that the university made all sorts of concessions in July, but none of them were to replace the school's anthem, "The Eyes of Texas." They changed a building that was once named for a racist who no longer wanted to let black students into his math class. They finally have realized that it's a good thing for them to recognize Julius Witter as the first Black letterman of Texas football in 1970. For perspective there, Oklahoma had its first Black letter winner in 1956, and the first Black letter winner at Ohio State and Michigan, 19th century, 1890, 1891, okay? Texas is behind on these things. We also have lots of data to show that Texas was far behind the rest of the country when it came to integrating its school system. And I read a really great book about Earl Campbell that Asher Price wrote that I really think you all should take a look at and go read, because it gives you a little bit more insight into just how backward the University of Texas was. Now, knowing that the players did not want to stand for the Eyes of Texas, knowing that Sam Ehlinger did, I believe that some folks want to see this as school pride. I think that humanity should trump school pride every single time, because without humanity, there is no school. And without Black football players, Texas is still just that squad that refused to integrate, and is still just that squad that was the last of the national champions to have an all-white squad in 1969. Now, if you sing the Eyes of Texas, that's on you. I know this. Black folks know. We just don't engage in it, right? And there's lots of conversation to be had about this, but I think it speaks volumes that Jay Hartzell had an opportunity to remake the University of Texas's image around that song and chose not to. Instead, we're here in October talking about Sam Ehlinger standing by his lonesome as the Eyes of Texas are being played and the coaching staff is behind him, which I think speaks about what we genuinely believe is right or wrong with the country as it stands, right? You can't separate college football from racism, just as you can't separate the United States of America from racism, and continuing to push forward this narrative that, hey, he stood with them and they won't stand with him is wrong, because this is a football game. They lost a football game. Black Lives Matter is about protesting police brutality. It's about systemic racism. It's about acknowledging that white supremacy is bad and that there are things that black, but mostly white folks can do to help counteract that and to counterattack that and to make the world a more equitable and equal place for you and I to be. Now, I believe Sam Ehlinger should be able to do what Sam Ehlinger's doing. But if you're going to talk about it in the context of his player or his teammates leaving him hanging out to dry, you're totally missing the point. You haven't actually been paying attention. Because let's talk about Sam Ehlinger standing for school pride and more conversation about the courage of those black players to say, no, we no longer will engage in this. We don't want to be engaged in this. Because they, like him, were putting themselves on the line to try to go win a football game against the University of Oklahoma. And by on the line, I mean playing college football, which is inherently violent and inherently injurious. Meanwhile, people want to talk about how courageous Sam Ehlinger was. He threw the pick that sealed the game for Oklahoma. So there's lots of different ways you could talk about this, but I want to be sure that we're talking about it in the right way and not in a way that tries to make this even more divisive an issue than it already is. All right, that's it for me. Deuces.